Hello everyone, this is HR Elite Team representing CTAMS. Our topic is about history of HR. In 1912, Tata Steel became the first company to limit the number of working hours for a factory workers to 8. In 1914, this act was adopted by Henry Ford. In 1919, the Works Committee was formed in Tata Steel to handle complaints, service conditions and grievances institutionalized as the Government of India in 1947 by Industrial Dispute Act. In 1920, Leave with Pay, Provident Fund, Workman Accident Compensation was introduced by Tata Steel. In 1921, DuPont designed the first ever multidimensional organization structure. In 1928, maternity benefit was introduced by Tata Steel. In 1943, Abraham Maslow explored what motivated people beyond survival and introduced hierarchy of needs. They are self-actualization, esteem, social safety, and physiology. In 1945, the world's first educational institution dedicated to workplace studies, a school of industrial and labor relations, was formed at Kurnool. In 1949, XLRI Jamshedpur was founded that curses in management and trade unions were kicked off. In 1953, Heydrich and Struggles was found a first in organized recruitment and leadership council. In 1969, ABC Consultant founded by Bush Agarwal became the first organized recruit firm in India. In 1970, getting people to do what you want them to do in performance management was coined by Sir Aubrey Daniels. In 1973, David McClung started the US of Competency in People Management. In 1974, Carson and Turbo became the first organization to set up an HRD department. In 1977, Rosabeth Moss Kantner, a professor at Harvard's Business School, published Men and Women of a Corporation as a landmark work on corporate cover that is related to women. In 1984, Vinnie F. Casico addressed the need to justify the cost and efficiency of the HR function. In 1985, the Annette Hardian was conceived. In 1990, Edward introduced the concept of strategic pay. Non-financial performance measures was emphasized in the balanced scorecard. In 1996, Dave Ulrich defined the term called strategic plans of a strategic partners. A four rules called the employee champion, the change agent, the administrative expert and the strategic partner. In 2000, Ricardo Semler, the CEO of Semco Brazil, introduced a system that could pay. In 2008, Cali Russell and Jody Thompson co-created Results Only Works Environment. In 2012, Adobe abolished annual performance review. In 2013, Big Data became the next buzzword in HR. Thank you.